Paleontologists have found the remains of a plesiosaur, the aquatic monster that is most associated with the Loch Ness monster. This particular specimen broke a record for body size and was found in Antarctica. It's being called the world's heaviest sea monster, and I bet blue whales are super jealous right now. Welcome back to InformOverload. We do the news and spill the tea and Loch the Ness. I'm Charlotte Dobre, and on this channel, we've been keeping you up to date with the Loch Ness monster. I've always been obsessed with the Loch Ness monster, and I think it's because I used to watch Happiness as a kid. Do you guys remember Happiness? That like 90s children's cartoon? Man, I love that. I was obsessed with the idea that the Loch Ness monster could exist, but guess what? It did exist. It was a type of plesiosaur. By the way, if you're new here, why don't you hit that subscribe button and give me a like, because the Raptors won last night. The plesiosaur was a marine reptile with four flippers that lived millions of years ago. Elasmosaurs, one of the largest plesiosaurs, the ones with the long necks, those are the sea monsters that people think could be the Loch Ness monster. Researchers from the Argentine Antarctic Institute published an article in the journal Cretaceous Research that provides details about the largest elasmosaur ever found. This specimen is 36 feet long from snout to tail, which for some perspective is about as long as a telephone pole. It is the largest elasmosaurid ever found, weighing at almost 15 tons when it was alive. The specimen has been nicknamed Nessie, which is quite appropriate if you ask me. It turns out that elasmosaurs were pretty common in Antarctica back in the day. The fact that this specimen was so large means that it probably ate a lot, which isn't surprising when you consider the large mammals like humpback whales that currently exist in Antarctica during feeding and breeding seasons. Plesiosaurs swam around with their mouths open, collecting and swallowing fish. Kinda sounds like a whale if you ask me. A whale of a tail. This specific fossil was so big that it actually took 3 trips to fully extract. It was first discovered back in 1989 by William Zinsmeister from Purdue University. Zinsmeister came across the fossils near the Antarctic Peninsula, but he didn't have the funding to dig further into the rock to extract it. Then researchers went back in 2005, again in 2012, and again in 2017. I mean, this is Antarctica we're talking about. Excavations were really difficult because of harsh weather, and the fossil was located in a remote area. Snowstorms prevented excavations from taking place, but thankfully fossils usually stay in place. Hint, they're dead. They're not going anywhere. I guess like erosion, but you get what I mean. So it was still there even 20 years later. In total, scientists collected 1,760 pounds of fossilized bones that were embedded within rocks on Antarctica's Seymour Island. In addition to being the largest fossil of its kind ever found, it is also one of the most complete. They have pretty much everything except the skull, which is like, who needs skulls anyway? Not me! The fossils were hidden in the Lopez de Bertadano formation, 7.5 feet below the geologic line that shows the Cretaceous Paleogene extinction. The Cretaceous Paleogene extinction was 66 million years ago. You know, it was when that like 6-mile-long asteroid collided with Earth and killed off all the dinosaurs. This particular plesiosaur probably lived about 30,000 years before the mass extinction, making the fossil 70 million years old. If this particular elasmosaur was as humongous as it was, it means that elasmosaurs were thriving before the mass extinction. Who knows, maybe some of them even survived until relatively modern day, which is why there are so many legends and myths about sea monsters, one of them being the Loch Ness monster. Elasmosaurs were terrestrial, air-breathing dinosaurs that are believed to have been warm-blooded. That means that elasmosaurs had to poke their heads out of the water every few seconds, which could have explained a lot of the sightings over history. We did a recent video about scientists who went to the Loch and are reporting that it may actually exist. If you want to watch that, it is clickable on your screen right now. Alright, kids, it's about that time. Comment time. Are you ready? Juan Ramirez said, hearing Charlotte say ain't makes me cringe every time. Jesus, now I can't say ain't? Ain't. Some of you are so sensitive. The only time I cringe at anything is when someone is doing something totally and completely embarrassing. Like Fergie singing the US national anthem. That is cringeworthy. Not me saying ain't. Settle down.
Oh, it's so cringy. She said a word. Oh.
Camellia Blossom said, just love these videos, can't get enough. You're so pretty, you're a good queen of potatoes. Enjoy your day, everyone. Everyone else enjoy your day. You're cute. You enjoy your day too. The mystical K1KO said, Mother Potato, adopt me please. Dude, I couldn't even keep my basil plant alive for longer than 2 weeks. You do not want to be my child. Jackson Stockett said, so this is my first time watching and you can take my potato.
Gimme.
Antonio V said, your arms are so long. I don't think they fit in the frame. That's because I'm tall. If you're tall, you have long arms. And I'm also very good at hugging myself. That's it for this video. Thanks for watching. If you want to keep watching, there's a playlist right over here with a bunch of videos just like this one. And obviously, if you like this video, you should leave a thumbs up, subscribe, and turn on notifications, and I will see you in a future IO video. Okay? Bye.